Welcome to Big D, Dallas, Texas, and the house the Pony Express built. Dickerson and James and SMU hoping to restore the glory and get things started in this one. There's just something about the nightcap. After a day of wall-to-wall football, it just seems this is when chaos ensues. As we'll see a squad from the Big 12, the BYU Cougars, taking on a team from the ACC, the SMU Mustangs. Glad to have you with us for EA Sports College Football. I'm Reese Davis, David Pollack, and Jesse Palmer with me in the booth. Guys, we are ready to tee it up. And the Mustangs will kick it away first. Here he comes from inside his own five. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. So BYU's offense takes the field. And here's the man they rally around, and he has earned that type of respect, David.
You dang right. You earn it by doing it, and he's done it at such a high level. Everyone believes in this young man, and Palmer, there's a reason why.
You're right, David. He's been in the big moments, and he's...
Oh, look out! He's at the 40. And that was a huge run that almost went to the house. The defense kept him from scoring.
How about the offensive line working in tandem on these blocks? You see some of those guys that got up into the second level, got a hat on a hat, and that left open a huge crease for the running back.
This attack so lethal with that big play capability. Now first and 10 from the 29. Might as well run him until they stop him. He's got it again. Able to pick up a couple down to the 27.
And offenses want to continue to feature the run. They want balance. Even if it's not super successful, you can take it little bit at a time just to keep that defense honest.
After picking up a couple at second and 8. Looking for room, it's Martin. Shows him the stiff arm. Worked it down to the 22-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry.
It's really frustrating when you get a guy in his spot. He's in the hole. He's there to do his job. And he can't get the guy on the ground. That's your job. Get him on the ground. You know, especially a guy that's not a huge back. You got to make that tackle. You can't make it easy on the offense when now they got a manageable situation.
On third and short, they'll go to the power running game. Looks as if BYU will have a first down.
You know, this is a running back who wants the ball, and he wants the offense to run through him. Really nice job there on the third down of this opening drive for his offense. I can't wait to see what kind of game this guy's going to have.
Now inside the 20, first and 10 from the 18. They're looking to pass from the red zone. Grabbed over the middle. It's Hill. They go up top to get it down to the 5-yard line as they try to pay off this drive. That throw and catch, a really good example of why coaches don't want a quarterback to get stuck on a particular target, isn't it, David?
Yep, that's exactly right. Find the guy who's open, because you got so many guys that have so much speed that can do so much damage on the field. Find my matchup, get it to him, let him do the rest.
And the defense makes a big hit and knocks him down.
And a really nice job by the wide receiver. You run a drag route, find space. They're in zone coverage. They're not covering man-to-man. Find a little hole. Look at that QB. Y'all get on the same page. You could tell they were, and that's why they got the first down.
Now on second and goal. Trying to slam in. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, he gets tackled down at the 1-yard line, so offensively, do you feel confident enough on third here trying to hand it off again?
Yeah, and I'm taking both these downs, and I'm coming downhill. I'm running the football, trying to get this in the end zone. I only got a yard to go. I got to be physical.
This is the 7th play of the drive as they come to the line on third and goal. Into the end zone he goes. Touchdown, BYU!
Well, the offense goes as he goes, so really no surprise in the opening drive. They keep feeding him the football. He showed you all of his ability on that TD.
He'll try to tack on one more. And the extra point makes it 7-0. So a well-executed 8-play, 75-yard drive. And they capped it off with a 1-yard plunge. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And he takes this from inside the 5. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. So the SMU Mustangs offense has its first opportunity of the day. One thing to watch, can this guy get in the quarterback's head and make him take a peek at the rush, David?
Dang, Skippy, that's what you want to do. You want to make this guy a little bit more human and not as much of a game breaker at the quarterback spot? Get some pressure on him, hit him a few times.
He's one of the best quarterbacks in the country, but he can't hurt you if he's laying on his back, and this defensive end can put him there often.
Yeah, and a really good job by the defender understanding the ball's coming. I got to break on it and go and not try to intercept it and make a bad play. He swats it down to make sure that's an incompletion.
He'll do it himself. And they pick up just one. It'll be 3rd and 9.
Yeah, and it's a nice job by this defense understanding, listen, that QB is a threat. And they're going to run all kinds of options, and he's going to run the football. They were dialed in and got that sucker to the ground.
They line up with some serious work to do if they want to convert this one. 3rd and long, and he'll try to throw for it. And that's incomplete. A defender all over him knocked the ball to the ground. 4th down coming up.
This is a point where you just got to be able to focus. And the critical down and distances in this game, like that 3rd down right there, when it's a good throw, you got to make the catch. You've got to be able to make that play.
The Mustangs send out the punt unit. He'll settle for some pretty good field position and make the fair catch at around the 35. The BYU offense headed back out to go on the attack. The give to the running back from the shotgun. They pick up half of it. It'll be 2nd and 5.
I like this guy as a running back because he can run between the tackles and he can also go outside. He can really do it all.
Halfway there on 1st down, it's 2nd and 5. He's looking to throw. He lets one fly deep. And he makes the grab and gets the foot down. What a job for a huge gain there.
Yeah, and the quarterback knew exactly where he wanted to go with the football, had time, spins the ball deep. Nice job by this offense, understanding what the defense is giving them and creating the explosive play.
BYU lines up quickly. He wants to throw. Got his man in the middle.
Well, it's a great job by the receiver fighting back across the DB there to get to the inside, locate the ball, and catch the slant.
Here comes the offense on 2nd down. He's looking to throw. Got it set up on the outside. And they wrap him up, but not before he's got enough for the 1st down.
Well, it's a nice play design there. You're getting the running back involved in the pass game. Quarterback gives it to him early so he can go to work upfield and get the 1st down.
BYU has this offense clicking. From the red zone, looking for a space. He caught it! And he was thinking 6, but that D knocks him down at the 2.
Stop me when you've heard this before. 1st down. 1st down. 1st down. Just continuing to put 1st downs together. So far, this defense, I just can't find any answers.
The Cougars will try to punch it in on 1st and goal. They'll try to slam it in. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, BYU!
Another rushing touchdown. That's now 2 on the game. This offense thought they could come into this one running the ball, being the more physical team, and they look like it right now.
lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point makes it 14-0. So that scoring drive took only 6 plays and closed the deal with a 3-yard touchdown run. Kickoff team has the ball teed up and they're about ready to go. On the run from inside his own 5. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. The SMU offense is headed back onto the field. To say this has been a slow start is a bit of an understatement, and they really need to get it going here, Jesse.
That's right. The opponent, they're firing on all cylinders right out of the gate. Offensively for this unit, they've been slow and struggling. They need an explosive play to wake themselves up.
Yeah, and it's just the first quarter, so it's not the end of the world. You've seen slow starts, but you got to continue to pick and pick and pick until you find that play or that scheme that you can use against this defense.
He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 3.
You want to end a play quickly? Get in the backfield that fast, get to the guy, and get him on the ground. Nice job penetrating right from the snap, getting off the ball so quick, penetrating the backfield and making something happen.
Here on 3rd down. It's a draw. Really nice job to get it past the sticks, pick up the 1st down at the 30.
Well, I know this is an offensive line that has a ton of pride, and they want to come out each and every game and really impose their will on the D-line. They got just enough push there on that run play to pick up the 1st.
That's the end of the quarter, and BYU is on top. They came out and jumped on them early in the 1st. Let's take a break and look at the 1st quarter stats. Now the challenge here, they've taken a punch, but they can't let it get out of hand as we start the 2nd. They've got him looking run. Now they're going to throw it. Makes the catch down the right side. And there was lots of space as he gets it to the 39-yard line.
That's what's so scary about this offense. They've got guys in the perimeter that can change the game in one single play, and you saw it right there. Too much speed on the perimeter to create that explosive play.
And the Mustangs are in the hurry up. Running back searching for a hole. After the pickup of 9, it's 2nd and 1.
Yeah, this coaching staff, they're getting this offensive line lathered up and into a rhythm. Now they're letting them drive off the ball on 1st down on these running plays, and they're getting chunks of yardage.
After the 9-yard pickup on 1st down, here's 2nd and 1. Trying to impose their will with the run. Wrestled to the ground after picking up the 1st down.
And this offense is clicking, everything's moving, and the guy carrying the football, I mean, he is carrying the rock. Like, this is a guy he's setting this tone for this game, creating some balance on this offense. This offense is going to be a handful.
Yeah, David, I'd love to sit here and say, well, the offensive coordinator is just one step ahead of his counterpart across the field. That's not it. Right now, his offensive line is a step.
And the catch and run into the end zone. Touchdown, SMU!
And what a nice start for this offense. The throw game getting working, getting the touchdown pass. This quarterback getting a little bit of confidence. This passing game getting in a rhythm. Nice start for this offense.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. And after the extra point, they've cut the lead in half, down 14-7. They put together an 81-yard drive, and they finish things off with a 21-yard touchdown pass. the kickoff team on the field as they'll send this one away. He'll start the return inside his five. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. BYU has it back. The Cougars ready to get into that playbook. Now they'll run the draw. He's brought down, but there's a flag on the field. Let's see what the call is. Holding penalties, the ultimate drive killer. We'll see if it costs this offense here. From the gun, leaves it on the inside with the back. They make the stop, but not before he takes a chunk out of what they need to move the sticks.
You want to talk about making it easy for an offensive coordinator. You pick up a bunch of yards on first down, make that second down really, really manageable. That's a great job by the offense.
Ball's on the 18. It's second down and 9. Motion from the offense. The give from the gun. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Great job by the defense. Everybody firing off the ball, hitting their guys, holding their gaps, running to the football, nowhere to go.
You make up the game plan and not a lot on the play sheet for this. Third and long from inside their own 20. From the gun, wants to pass. Right down the middle. Fires into traffic, picked off. And they'll close in on him after a good return on the interception.
And I tell you what, when defenses play zone, all eyes are on the quarterback. You have a zone to drop to, but you're setting on the quarterback, reading his eyes. Great job by the defense, understanding the ball was coming out, breaks on the football, goes and makes the INT.
The Mustangs have the ball back and ready to go to work. That last touchdown drive was surgical through the air, Jesse.
It sure was, and that's why this offense is so dangerous, David, because they can score in a hurry because of how efficient they are throwing the football.
And welcome to modern college football. That's what it is. Spread you out, find my playmakers, make quick decisions, and really put defenses in a difficult situation.
The incompletion brings us to second and 10. To the air, it's Stone. Immediately fires to the middle. He's there to make the stop, but the damage has been done as they pick up the first down on the throw and catch.
And that is a different collision. When you're trying to hit the tight end after he catches the football, this ain't a 185-pound wide receiver. Most of these guys, 240, 250, 260, try to go low, take out those ankles. And you see a lot of times that's when they hurdle or they're used to it too, but those big, strong athletes are hard to get to the ground.
Going to work on second down in the red zone is still some ground to cover to pick up that first down. Wide receiver coming across in motion. That's what you expect from a senior. Don't give them any extra yards. Great tackle there.
You know, I really like this QB running the football because I know he's got a lot of speed, but he's not the biggest guy in the world. So he's not going to be able to break a lot of tackles. You really got to do a good job of trying to scheme ways to get him out in more space.
On third down, he'll try to pick it up through the air. Pass is incomplete, but there is a flag, and the D might have been a little too rough on the quarterback there. You just can't hit the quarterback like that. The defender got caught red-handed. Quick pass on the jet motion. Pulled down for the tackle.
Well, and on these little push passes, timing is so important. You're trying to snap it right as he's getting a full head of steam. When he gets the ball, he's hitting the outside. And, David, it puts the defense in such a difficult spot.
You immediately have to be rotating when you see that motion. So everybody's got to communicate and kind of bump over. That's why offenses love to run it. Just it makes the defense communicate and see if you can just get him out of a spot.
Quarterback on the keeper. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 3.
Really, really nice football play. Man, I got to understand option football. I got to play my responsibility, make sure that I know what I'm doing. Look at the linebacker. Great job doing that. Staying patient, getting to the quarterback, making the big tackle.
They'd love to make this short field pay off with a touchdown instead of settling for three, but it is third and goal. Just threw that one away to avoid disaster.
Yeah, and third and short, they choose not to run, throw the football, and I think a lot of that has to do with they know they're in field goal range. They can take the 3 points on the board.
Now on fourth down, here comes the field goal team. From the left hash, this one shouldn't be too much trouble. Just drives it between the uprights. So after the last drive ended with a field goal, the kickoff team out there to send it away. He'll bring it back looking for help. And good work by the coverage team to get the return man down on the ground. The BYU offense headed back out to go on the attack. They'll throw it on first down. Got it in the middle, it's Green. And that is good versatility there and a big hit from the backer in pass coverage.
I'll say this, man. In college football, you see a lot of bad tackling. You didn't see it right there. That was an awesome job. First off, being there at the point of attack, once the tight end made the catch, there was no doubt he was going down. Great job, form tackle.
On second down, he'll let it fly. Snags it down the right side. Off he goes. Inside the 10. And he cruises his way to the house. Touchdown, Cougars.
This offense is so explosive, they can change the scoreboard in a flash. You just saw that on that drive.
Ready to try the point after. And with the extra point, it's a 21-10 game. This offense prides itself on going after you, and they did with that long touchdown pass to finish off a two-play drive. Just about set to kick it away. He'll bring it back from inside his five. And the returner could find no daylight. He goes down. The SMU offense is headed back onto the field. They had to settle for the chip shot field goal last time, Jesse. They'd love for this one to pay off bigger.
Yeah, it just comes down to execution, too. Did a nice job out in the field, stalled a little bit once they got down to the goal line, so they just need to be a little bit more crisp here, though.
Yeah, and listen, I think the first part was the most important part. You got to put the drive together first to get down there. Now, when we get down there, focus on execution and getting 6 points.
We've reached the two-minute warning, and this thing has been one-sided, and they hope to at least have something to feel good about going into halftime. That's the type of explosive play you love to start a drive with. First down from the 42. He's going to pass. Quickly complete. And the defense had that one well covered, just a short game there.
I like the decision by the quarterback here. Just get the ball out of your hands, get it to your playmaker. A lot of times he'll dance and make even bigger plays than he did here, but it was still a positive game.
Quick tempo, no huddle offense. Second down, clock's running. To the air, it's Stone. Throws to the wideout. And that pass picked off. Going the other way, and he's got room. He's at the 10, and he's going to take it all the way back. Touchdown, Cougars! Look, I know it's only the second quarter, but we're starting to see a pretty significant gap develop between these two teams right now.
No doubt. When your defense is scoring, your offense is scoring, good things happening for your ball club. This defense on point, reading their scouting report, making big plays.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And with the extra point, they push the lead out a little further. They're lining up to kick it off after the pick six, and that defense will come out feeling it. On the move from inside his five. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. The Mustangs have the ball back and ready to go to work. Boy, they've been caught in a buzzsaw here in the first half, but maybe a chance to carry some momentum into the break here.
It all comes down to this drive right here, Reese. Obviously, this offense hasn't had everything go right for them in the first half, but here's an opportunity, David, to execute some plays, put some throws together, and generate some points.
And you're right, Jesse, and this offense needs to start now. Like, we got to get some points on the board, create some momentum, and continue it, because you've dug yourself a significant hole.
On second down, just keeps firing. Fires to the wideout. Got it in the middle, it's Bailey. Running wide open down the gut of the field. And he eluded the defense, and he'll take it all the way. Touchdown, Mustangs!
And I tell you what, that passing touchdown, man, that should spark this whole team. Like, the comeback is more than on now. Like, they got the touchdown, they cut into the lead. You want to get a stop and go into the half, get all the juices, all the excitement, and be like, listen, the passing game's rolling. We got this. The comeback's in full effect.
They'll try to tack one more on their score. And they make the extra point to draw closer. It's 28-17. That drive, a great example of just how potent this offense can be. Two plays, 80 yards, give them the touchdown. They've cut into this lead. It's down to 11 as they're set to kick it away. Here he comes from inside his own five. And the coverage team gets the returner on the ground. BYU has it back. The Cougars ready to get into that playbook. They've got some time to work with here, Jesse, and if they get a first down, they might really get aggressive.
I'd be aggressive right out of the gate. I'd be throwing for a first down. If I get it, then it's pedal to the metal. I'm in that two-minute mode to try to score a touchdown or get a field goal.
But I do think this is a situation where you also have to understand that I have the lead. Going into the half, I've got the momentum, so don't do anything stupid here.
Looking to go up top on first down. A strike downfield. The offense wastes no time getting the timeout call.
All right, defense, it ain't working, right? They're stringing together several first downs here. We're going to need to change this up, find something we can disrupt the quarterback and mess up this offense a little bit.
Trying to find his man on first down. Gets open down the middle. They make the stop right there. Good pickup, and still short of the first down. The offense calls timeout, and they won't have any more left this half. They'll line up for a second down play. He's looking to throw. Coming after him. And that's just a flat misfire, not even close to his receiver.
And that's a really good decision by the quarterback. Don't take the sack, throw the ball away. Now listen, we can debate whether that was intentional grounding or not because he's still in the pocket. I'm not sure that that's not classified as grounding, but they didn't call it. So you know what? Nice throwaway, QB.
On third and short, they'll try to throw for it. Pressure coming. And a little too much adrenaline on that throw never gave his receiver a chance.
job by the defense there. They weren't surprised by that play call there on third and short. They were expecting pass. They took everything away and forced the incompletion.
Time dwindling away as they try to put points on the board right before the half. On fourth down, he'll try to toss it. And it's incomplete and the defense holds. First down here for the offense. Looking to throw, it's stolen. Pocket starts to collapse. Flips it out in the flat. And he is run out of bounds as they go backwards there and just avoided the contact. One more play before the teams head to the locker rooms. Wants to fire on second down. He lofts it high and deep down the left side. Pass is incomplete and half comes to a close on that play. That's the end of the second quarter. That means it's time to join Kevin in our halftime update.
Guys, time for everyone inside that stadium in Dallas to take a deep breath and kind of digest what we just saw. The passing game for both sides has been outstanding. On point, unrelenting. They've excelled in the short game, the intermediate game, and especially on the deep ball. All in all, a thrilling display of offensive firepower, and these defenses have a lot to discuss here at halftime. And with that, let's send it back to the guys at Gerald J. Ford Stadium.
BYU will try to boot it deep to start the second half. And he takes this from inside the five. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. The SMU offense is headed back onto the field. Pulled and finds his man on the left.
And there you see the bind that the RPO play can put a defender in. That linebacker had to make a decision. Was the running back going to get the ball? He thought so, he bit up, and that allowed the slant to be thrown in behind him.
The Mustangs want to crank the tempo. From the shotgun, the handoff to the back. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses four on the carry.
Goodness, that happened fast. He was in the backfield before the ball was even snapped.
Oh, man, adrenaline pumping, heart beating a little faster. There is some intensity on that one. And this offense can ill afford to come up empty on this drive, already trailing by multiple possessions. He's got it down the right side. Running toward the tape. Touchdown, SMU! A Lazarus-like comeback is underway. Quick strike touchdown comes out and jump-starts the offense.
And man, we see this in college football. So much explosiveness and firepower, and we get high-scoring game after high-scoring game, and it looks like we're on pace for one of those right now.
They'll try to get the two-point conversion here and make it a three-point game. Slams it ahead. He's going to be stopped short as they come up empty on the two-point try. They were hoping to get this game to within a field goal, but the lead stays at five. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. Let's see if he can make a play on the return. Good job by the coverage unit to put a stop to that return. The BYU offense headed back out to go on the attack. These last couple of drives, Jesse, have been about the defense making clutch stand.
I think for this offense, they can stay aggressive knowing that their defense is going to bail them out time and time again here.
Yeah, and especially when you go for those fourth down situations, you do that a lot of times because you know your defense can make stands, make stops. They did on that last possession for you.
Now on first and 10 from the 27. Right back to the well. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
At some point, enough is enough. This is the guy that's beat me. He's priority number one. We got to go get him. It's getting later in the second half. I got to go out and make some plays and get my offense the ball back.
Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. On the run, it's Martin. Surges across the 30, out to the 32, a 6-yard run.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting what was blocked, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
After the last run, would you just give it to him again on third down? From the gun, wants to pass. Complete downfield. That defense got gassed, but they finally get him to the turf at the 47.
Well, I think on that play, you saw why this guy's such a big weapon in this offense. At receiver, he does such a nice job with his routes. He's patient, and he's consistent, and he's got good hands. You don't see him put a lot of balls on the ground. Nice job there picking up the first down.
Grab behind the line. It's Roberts. The defense wouldn't let him loose, and even though it's a completion, they lost yardage.
Well, give the defense credit on that one, because they knew coming into this one that they were going to try to get this receiver the ball in a variety of ways. They were ready for the screen there, and they create a negative play.
Now on second down. The play action fake. Throws toward the end zone. And the incomplete pass, taking a shot on second down, and they'll be left with a third down.
Mano y mano, man. One-on-one go ball. Who's going to make a play? The defender steps up to the occasion, knocks that one away for an incompletion.
If they can convert here, that type of play can really give you a shot of momentum. On third down, going up top. Oh, they really could have used that catch there. Physical pass defense. It brings up a fourth down.
Third and long situations are really hard to convert. The defense knows it's going to be passed. The pass rushers are getting upfield. You're under pressure. You don't have timing. And as a result now, fourth down.
BYU will bring the punt team on the field. He ought to be able to use his first punt to pin them deep. The punt goes out of bounds, and a nice job to get them backed up. I think they'll spot it right around the 15. The Mustangs have the ball back and ready to go to work. He'll try the left side. Nifty little dance step. He will step out of bounds, but not before the big pickup and a first down for this offense.
It's so nice as an offense to know you can generate explosive plays by handing the football off to this guy. He has got incredible speed.
They'll put it in play from the 27, first down. Unloads quickly. You'll take this every time, 5 yards on the first down play.
My old coach said you'll never go broke taking a profit. Take what's there, take the positive yards, and never complain.
After the run, second and medium. Back to throw, it's Stone. Receiver looks it in, it's complete. And a good job in coverage there as they stop it after just a few.
You see it more and more. Smaller wide receivers, I don't care about their size anymore. I put them in the slot. I let them get a good matchup. They're so quick, people can't get their hands on them. They make plays, and I feed them the football. These are guys that have a lot of catches throughout a season.
Fires to the tight end. He's out of bounds, but not before picking up enough for the first down.
So difficult, because my eyes tell me as a defensive guy, he's handing it off. The offensive line's blocking run. I got to go get it. Quarterback pulls it, throws it to the right. It's kind of like that hidden hat game. Like, where's the ball? I'm always trying to find that daggone thing.
And the Mustangs are on the move. Pulls and throws off the RPO. He's run out of bounds, but not before. Turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down.
And a big key on that throw to the slot receiver, guys, is putting the ball out in front. The location of the throw is what helped that guy get extra yards after the catch.
The Mustangs will snap it on first and 10. They'll give it to the back. Not much working there. It'll be second and 9.
I never know if it's grammatically correct to say a team is being out-physicaled. You hear it a lot in football, though. That's happening in this game. They are just not getting the push they need all game long up front to have any success when they decide to run it.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and 9. He's looking to throw. A little screen to the running back. They finally get him stopped, but what a good job by that front wall to set up the screen and create some lanes for their running back.
And man, this quarterback has had a day. With that pass, he goes over 300 yards on the day. Really nice job executing, putting up some yards today. Pretty good day for the young man.
Inside the 30 at the 29, it's a first down. Use the play fake, now to throw. A shot toward the end zone. Touchdown, Mustangs! They look finished, but they're all the way back, and they have the lead.
One of the areas they really focused on with this receiver in the offseason was, we need you to make more plays for us in the end zone. When we're taking shots, we need you to be able to step up and make tough catches. And David, what a grab right there.
And I think a lot of that has to do with trusting your guy, knowing where he's going to be, knowing when he's going to sit down, when he's not. So being on the same page, and then having a guy that can go get it. Just when the ball is near him, he's going to make the play, just like he did right there for 6 points.
Looking to pass, it's Stone. And he had it for a second, but it just dribbled out of his hands. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And he's going to bring it out of the end zone. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. BYU has it back. The Cougars ready to get into that playbook. Now they find themselves behind, David. Let's see if they have an answer.
Yep, losing the lead, obviously lose a little bit of momentum, but this offense, you can gain it right back, Palmer. Let's get a drive starter going. Find some guys you know you're going to make some plays for.
So that's the challenge for them. You got to answer, right? You got to take the field here. You got to execute, be physical, and regain this lead.
That kind of pickup on first down, and you can take a shot here on second and short. He's looking to throw. And the Heat will get home, and the quarterback goes down at the 17.
That's a good example there of complementary defense. The DBs and linebackers are playing zone. They're playing their spaces, and they force the QB to have to hold the ball, try to work through his progressions, and then the pass rush. They win up front.
Now on third and 10, if they can move the chains here, maybe they can get this drive started. From the gun, wants to pass. Wide open downfield. And they'll finally catch up to him, but not before a big chunk of yardage is picked up. And you want to talk about his favorite receiver, it might be everybody, based on the number of guys getting touches and a chance to show off their hands in the passing game. When you're dealing with a deficit like this, it's all about somebody stepping up to make a play, and you might as well start here in the fourth quarter. The RPO, fire complete to the left. Really nice job there by both guys, the throw and the catch, to work that defense and get the first down.
One of the things that makes this guy so dangerous is how good he is after the catch. If he's got any space around him, he's able to burst. He's able to make people miss and get extra yards for his offense. You saw it right there.
They'll ride the running back and leave it with him. Aird is trying to flex the muscle. They get him down at the 34 after a pickup of 4.
You know, it's so important for offenses to want to keep third downs manageable. The way you do that is by having success like that, running the football on first down.
Solid pickup of 4 on first down. It's second and 6. He's looking to throw. Fires to the big fella. They get him on the ground after he gets enough to move the sticks.
It's not a great feeling on defense, too. When you're blitzing, you're expecting to get a sack. You're expecting to get a hit on the quarterback. If the offensive line and running backs pick it up, uh-oh, because now you have one less guy in the back end trying to cover all these receivers and tight ends, and you know you're in trouble.
Grabbed behind the line, it's Roberts. And a quick completion, an even quicker loss. The defense was right there to knock him down.
Well, that receiver's looking at his teammates like, guys, what's up? You're not going to block for me on the screen? Seriously? I just lost yards on a screen play. How does that happen?
Not many hiccups on this drive, but it's second and 13 now. It'll be a draw. Pirouettes away from the defense. And they're able to get him on the ground.
And I love this because you got second and really, really long. And what's the idea of the offensive coordinator? Get third and manageable. Nice job getting a run, not only a positive run. Shoot, you almost got the first down. Now you're set up for good success on third down.
BYU trying to make this red zone trip pay off. They'll try to pick it up on the ground. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three.
And these are the big decisions you have to make in a football game. How confident are you in your defense? That's all this decision comes down to. If I kick a field goal and I trust my defense, that's how this game could end. Or do I want to roll the dice because I don't believe in my defense?
So on fourth down, here comes the field goal kicker in a huge spot. No good. And guys, not only a miss, but a missed opportunity to take the lead. The SMU offense is headed back onto the field. Man, what a drive last time for the touchdown. That passing attack was lethal, David.
Yeah, and you know, you hear all these stupid commentators like me and Jesse talking about create balance, you know, run and pass. No, when you throw that good, spin the ball around.
So the defense has to find a way to affect the quarterback on this drive because last drive, he had way too much time to throw.
And the Mustangs moving quickly to the line. To the air on first down. Grabbed in the backfield. It's Bailey. And there is nothing doing on that one. You got the completion and nothing else to show for it.
I mean, getting suffocated right away. How about the DB? Just seeing that initially, pulling the trigger, getting to him, get him on the ground, get the tackle for a loss.
This offense has a second down play. To throw, it's Stone. Makes the grab down the middle. They get him down after he makes the catch.
You know, the defense doesn't have an answer for this slot guy right now. They may want to think about bracketing him, having a defender play to the outside and to the inside, probably some sort of zone coverage where you're trying to get two bodies, forcing the quarterback to have to go somewhere else with the ball.
Some third down conversions tougher than others. This one, a long one on third down from the 43. How about getting the foot down on that throw for the big completion?
Well, this guy's been a go-to guy for this offense all game long. We've seen that. And here on a critical third down late in the game with the lead, guess who shows up with another big one?
And wait just a second. The official's going to take a second look at this one. And the play will stand after the replay booth just does a little double checking to make sure. And it's incomplete. If you're going to take a hit like that, you might as well hang on to the ball.
Well, it's a nice job by the quarterback getting the ball out of his hands quickly on that RPO. He saw something he liked, just not on the same page with his receiver.
Couldn't make the connection last time. Let's see if they throw it again. From the gun, they'll try to impose their will. And they try the middle of this defense, and that is not happening.
That's a really good stop by the defense. Jesse, they need a few more. You've given up a bunch of yards on this drive and a bunch of plays, but all that matters is keeping them off the scoreboard.
Yeah, it's that bend, don't break mentality you're seeing right now, and this is the point where this defense has just got to lock in.
On third and long, he's going to have to throw for it. Just missed his man, gave him just a little too much.
Nice job by the defense there, mixing.
And it looks as if they've buzzed down. Replay wants to have another peek at that last play. So after reviewing the undisputable video evidence, the replay booth has decided to overturn the call. And it's right down the boulevard. After putting three on the board, the kickoff unit ready to go. What kind of field position can he help them with on the return? And the returner will be brought down. The BYU offense headed back out to go on the attack. Looking for room, it's Martin. And the defense finally makes the stop after the sweet run and good gain.
I tell you what, with this kind of success on the ground, I think you two knuckleheads could call plays. I mean, that's how easy it is for this offense right now. They got the ground game working. It's really easy. Now you can open up for other things, but you guys could even try your hand because they're dominating right now.
They move the tight end all over. They're getting this guy lathered up. Tackle is made at the 28 after a pickup of three.
It's just simple. Simple first down run, showing your physicality, setting your offense up in a good spot.
Got three on first down. It's second and seven. He's looking to throw. Quickly complete. And that defense doesn't allow a cutback, and they get him out of bounds after a short gain.
And man coverage, when they get up in your face and they make things hard, you want to be able to attack the whole field and get them leaning one direction and then break outside like you did there. Nice out route connection, nice chemistry between quarterback and wide receiver.
On third and short, they'll ride the running back here. Gets it to the 42-yard line, and that's a first down.
And, you know, big chunks like this don't happen unless you commit to the run game. You got to get those big boys up front into the game, understanding I want to knock people off the football, create some holes like you do here for my running back, make the game easy.
And the Cougars are moving quickly down the field. Wants to throw on first down. Buys a little extra time. Just broke the tackle and still on his feet. A really nice run and gain, and he gets down to avoid taking punishment.
It's the fourth quarter. Every second counts, right? It's a one-possession game. We're chasing the QB. He scrambles around, does such a great job getting positive yards, keeping this drive alive. We need to score badly. We got to keep drives alive like this. Wonderful job.
Got the quick pass, and he'll make his way out of bounds after the solid pickup.
It's so nice as a quarterback when you've got a guy like that working for you in the slot. He has such a good feel to find the open spaces in the defense. Just makes life so much easier for his quarterback.
Let's see what they've got on second down. He's looking to throw. Unloads to the wideout. Reacted well to the tip, but just couldn't squeeze the football. Instead of the turnover, it'll be third down.
Man, this late in the game, it's go time. I gotta have a score. I'm not worried about downs. I'm going through my two-minute script. We know what's coming. We practiced this all week. It's second down, incomplete pass, go to third down. If we need to go for it on fourth down, this offense just has to keep that high energy up and try to run these plays fast.
The throw to the outside is complete. And he's chased out of bounds, but not before he gets the first down, stops the clock, and has them on the move trying to get the late score. The Cougars come to the line with a fresh set of downs. Looking to throw it again. Got his man on the right. The offense gets a quick timeout at this point. Every second is precious. Operating in the red zone here on second down. The give on the inside. Makes a man miss. And it is a good idea to gang tackle. First guy couldn't get him. Second guy finally did.
And I don't care if I get it by 2, by 20, by 30, by 40. I just want to get the first down, understanding the situation, understanding where the sticks are. Doesn't have to be sexy, but I got to make sure I get to that stick, get to the first down mark.
He's looking to throw it. Going for 6. Touchdown, BYU! And they grab the advantage, taking the lead here in the 4th.
And some of these guys make it look so easy, but these are tight windows down here, man. There's not a lot of space on the field, and he drops back, knows exactly where he's going with the football, throws it in there, makes the play, and more importantly, now his team is in the lead in the 4th quarter.
If he makes this one, the lead will be 3, and at least a field goal won't beat you. And he knocks it through, and the lead is a field goal here in the 4th quarter. About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. On the run from inside his own 5. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. The Mustangs have the ball back and ready to go to work. Trying to start the drive with a pass. He's got it. And a pickup of better than 30 yards on that completion before the defense brings him down. They'll use a timeout here. You have to be certain at this point in the game. Wants to throw. It's Stone. He's got his man across the middle. Just what they were looking for, and he's got him set up in business at the 35 with a first down.
And that's just a timing route. And if I'm a quarterback and they're going to sit back in zone, when I run those crossers, man, I just wait for that zone window to open up, anticipate it a little bit, chunk that thing, and let my receiver do the rest of the work.
Going up top on first down. Throws to the wideout. Makes a connection. Quick timeout call by the offense after the play, trying to preserve every minute possible. Just outside the red zone, 1st and 10 from the 21. Looking to move it through the air. Fires toward the end zone. He just about put this game away. If he'd been able to hold on to that one instead, it's 2nd down.
I can't believe it. He had a chance to just end the game right there. If the defender makes the catch in the end zone, up a possession, this is ball game. But because he put it on the ground, this offense still has life.
Leaves it with the running back. And they try the middle of this stout defense, and they rise to the challenge. They'll use a timeout with 26 seconds left on the clock. Already well within field goal range. Wonder how aggressive they'll be on 3rd and long from the 22. And Shore tackling there to keep him from getting to the 1st down marker. So here we are on 4th down, and this field goal kicker is going to face all the pressure in the world. Timeout on the field and 4 ticks left to go. And they are coming out for what will be a huge field goal attempt. It's good, and that was dead solid perfect. David, Jesse, they find a way in the waning seconds to tie it up.
What a kick for that young man right there. And you just see the way it energized and galvanized his entire sideline. They've tied it up late. This thing's going to OT, and they look like they are ready to rock.
Coming down the stretch in the 4th, and we are all tied up, about set to kick it away. He'll start the return inside his 5. And the return man reaches the end of the line, and down he goes. Four quarters not enough to settle this one. We are headed to overtime.
And these teams have played so well, back and forth, evenly contested game. How about a little free football, Jesse?
Yeah, I love this, David. Free football. I'm finding out which of these two teams is the most mature. Who can settle down now with the game on the line and make the big play?
All right, guys, so here we go in overtime. And just to refresh everyone's memory, alternating possessions starting on the opponent's 25.
And it's so nice to be on defense first, just to set the tone, to understand what you need. Try to hold them to a field goal. The offense knows they can do their job to go out and get a win. Just two possessions, Palmer. Like, you got to be at your best.
Yeah, and I love the new rules, too, because in the third overtime possession, it goes to alternating two-point plays back and forth. Who's got anything left in the tank here in OT?
Finally run out of bounds, but he has this offense rolling with a first down. Using the quick game. He's down at the one, and they almost had the touchdown pass on that one. Offense trying to pay it off on second and goal. Direct snap. Touchdown, BYU! They jump on top here in OT. He has spent a lot of time in that end zone today. An absolute assault on the scoreboard.
No doubt about it. And guess what? I get to make a lot of highlights. I can copy and paste all of these touchdowns, show everybody the game I had. And the defense, well, you're just going to have to shake your head because you've been getting dominated.
The all-important extra point would push this lead to 7. And the extra point is true, and they're on top by 7. They know what's in front of them. They have to answer that score with a touchdown. Looking for a man. It's Stone. Going for it all. And they won't be able to connect downfield, looking for a big-time play. And the incompletion brings up a second down for this offense. He's looking to throw. Got his man quickly. They bring him down, but he's got a first and goal from the 10. First and goal as they try to answer with a touchdown of their own. Comes out throwing on first down. Touchdown, SMU! They got it in the end zone. Now a decision to make with a point after.
Obviously, very hard to complete passes in this area of the field. Nice execution. Now you're down by one, and now you got to make the decision. Are we going to go for it and try to end the game right here and put this game in our offense's hands? What do you think?
And that's why I love having the ball second, because I get the opportunity to do this. I knew they scored a touchdown. We scored a touchdown. Now, do I want to go for the win, or do I want to continue this game on? It's so nice to have the ball second.
They need this extra point to send it to double overtime. And he splits the uprights on the extra point. Here in the second overtime, they'll snap it on first down. They'll crank up this drive with the pass. A little release to the back. And that will go backwards. A negative play, and that defense on high alert that time. And here comes the offense on second down. He'll put the tight end in motion. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he makes the stop, but he got work done on the ground, picking up 6 to the 23. Quite a bit of work to do on third down from the 23, and this D would love to force a field goal try. Fires to the wideout. Makes the catch. Couldn't quite nudge it in. Not sure you could get much closer, but it'll be first and goal. First and goal. They'll try to take the lead here in the second overtime. Coming out on first down with the play fake. And he is snowed under, sacked at the 7. Defense rose up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a second and long coming. The offense showing motion from the tight end, trying to get a read on the D. He'll pull it on the read. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. They've got a little work to do here on third and goal in overtime. Third and goal, and they'll try to pass it in. Touchdown, Mustangs! Got it in to take the lead here in the second OT.
And how about the offense? They spread them out. Everybody spread wide. Easier to read a defense when you do that. They find the matchup they want, and they get rewarded with the score.
Second overtime, and they'll have to go for 2. Back to pass, it's Stone. They're bringing heat. They can't convert, and the lead remains at 6, and now they'll have to go on defense. Now on first down, they need to answer with a touchdown. They'll throw it on first down. Grabbed in the middle. It's Hill. They get him down, but this offense is set up first and goal from the 9. First and goal, down a touchdown. They have to get it in the end zone. From the gun. Fires into the end zone. Touchdown, Cougars. That ties it up here in double OT, and now they can win it.
I think the quarterback showed his head coach a lot on that last touchdown pass, the poise and the confidence. And because of that, David, on this upcoming two-point play, you might just put it back into his hands and let him go win it for
you. Yeah, man, I need it again, right? Like these rules, I got to go for 2. This is a clutch moment, obviously. Got to come up big. Do you trust him again? You worked on these two-point plays all year long, all week long. That's what you do. You know the rules. Now you got to go execute.
Have to go for 2 here in the second overtime, and this one would win the game. Looking to throw. He got it in there, and we are tied again. Is this fun or what? We're headed to triple OT.